Welcome back to Sunday Brunch Live. We're now joined by actor and comedian Gemma Whelan. You were a comedian first.
I was,
yes. You were,
yes.
Stand-up.
I did stand-up.
Did you know each other from the circus?
Yes, yeah. We did. Yeah, Gemma is very funny.
She
very
is.
Funny. Which is so strange when we see you on Game of Thrones, because you have to be so serious all the time. Did you ever just laugh on Game of Thrones?
Yeah, a lot.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
It's such a fun thing to do,
How did you get from comedian to Game of Thrones?
Right place, right time. I was doing a lot of sitcoms, and I was in an audition for a sitcom, and it was the same casting director as Game of Thrones, and he said, I think you might be right for something I'm casting at the moment, and that was Yara Greyjoy.
Greyjoy. Yara Greyjoy is a great name as well, isn't it? Yara Greyjoy could be like a fabulous sort of 70s sitcom. Do you know what I mean? Like,
sure.
Like Hetty Wainthrop.
Sure. Let's
Yara Greyjoy.
How was it completely life-changing when you got that role? Because it's something, Game of Thrones is so huge, isn't it?
Yeah, it's hard to quantify. Of course, like, having that on your CV definitely changes things. But in terms of, like, actually sort of that being a tangible thing in your life is hard to know, because you might have got an audition because of something else. But, of course, it really does help to have that.
Mm. Oh, yes. Okay. Do you miss the costumes?
No.
There
you go. Shut him down.
Oh, no. Fine.
There you
okay, are. That's the end of that.
Didn't you take the costume home with you, the boots?
I did take my boots home, yeah.
Are they comfy?
And I polished them.
Oh, wow.
Who knew?
Do you know what? As we're there, we were going to do, like, we might as well show a clip of you in Game of Thrones.
Oh, let's have a look.
When we reach Sunspear, I'll treat you to a Dornish red, the best in the world. Have you ever been to Dorne?
A few times. Never stayed long.
A boy in every port.
A boy, a girl. Depends on the port.
Oh, it's
so saucy,
Gemma.
Sunday morning.
So saucy on a Sunday morning. He didn't like it, did he? No, I'm off. No thanks.
You don't want to hear about your sibling. Anyway,
Alfie Allen was brilliant in Game of Thrones.
Oh, he's brilliant. Just a brilliant man.
In my family,
full stop.
And with Ramsay Bolton, that whole thing was just quite.
Oh yeah,
let's
chop.
Talk about that one. Let's
don't
talk
give away the
chop.
Ending. Don't give away the ending.
Now, that was
some of us haven't seen
before.
The end yet.
You haven't seen the beginning.
No, I haven't seen the beginning either. So. No, I've seen Gemma's bits.
Have you?
I've seen Gemma's bits. Yeah, yeah. When you did that funny arm, that funny handshake, I saw that bit.
Okay.
When you went over to the mainland. Do you remember that bit?
The elbow grab.
Yeah. Is that the thing?
Yeah,
what is it? Oh yeah.
Don't shake too much.
Don't
it took us about 20 takes to get it.
Serious.
The thing is about Game of Thrones, you get to see everybody's bits. Now, you're in...
Jim, don't be so base. You're disgusting. Sorry, Gemma.
I don't understand.
He's a bloke. He can't help it. Did you see that thing he did about cricket? Oh, it's so blokey. I wasn't invited to that interview, actually, because it was too blokey for me.
You're in a series, Gentleman Jack.
Yes.
Tell us about that one.
Sir Anne Jones plays Anne Lister. It's written by Sally Wainwright. And Anne Lister was a real woman who kept... She diarised her entire life in the 1800s, and she was a prominent lesbian. And she was... I say prominent lesbian. She was a very proud lesbian. Very, very... proud of who she was.
I love but she prominent was, lesbian.
She was prominent, but also she was a dynamo, and she was unapologetic, and she lived her life the way she wanted to live it, but there were certain aspects of her life that would be very frowned upon, so she diarised it in code. And the code was cracked relatively recently, and all these incredible stories spilled out onto the page. Sally Wainwright was obsessed with them for years and has now finally written a whole TV series based on this incredible woman who travelled the world and lived basically as a wife with a woman and did all the things that she wanted to do in her own way, and she was incredible, and it's her story.
Such a wonderful story.
And I play her sister. I'm in it.
Yeah. And what do you do?
No. I'm the annoying little sister who's got opinions about what her big sister's up to.
But what's so great about it is that it creates this whole world, and you as a sister are so funny, though, Gemma, like the way that you have these little looks, and you know, if I'm sure it's the same for maybe my sibling, that if you are a bit flamboyant, that, you know, the siblings, I think, do find it quite annoying that you have to put up with it and go like, yeah, all right, here we go. I mean, there's a clip of you here, I think, we can see.
How am I supposed to take it lying down? The fact that my sister, you certainly wouldn't, has cheated me out of what is rightly half mine.
No. You're going to have to let this go, Marion, for your own health. It's becoming an obsession, and it was never rightly half yours. It was entirely at Uncle James's disposal who he left the estate to, and we all know why he did.
I shall get married. I shall get married.
Oh, really? Oh, good.
And I shall have a child. Yes, really, a son.
Congratulations.
And one day he
will... You better look sharp about it, Marion.
You think I have no life outside these four walls?
Because you're no spring chicken.
Oh, you are sowing the wind hourly, daily, minute by minute, and you will reap the whirlwind.
Gemma must have been so fun.
Now.
Those big,
angry,
big puffy arms as well.
Don't wait to keep you mobile.
And your sandwiches.
Yeah.
Great.
You're also going to be filming, you've been filming in the Cotswold this week for a version of Jane Austen's Emma.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
What can you tell us about that?
I play Mrs. Weston, who is, at the beginning of the book, Miss Taylor, her governess, who remains her sort of confidant and dear friend throughout her journey as a sort of young woman growing up and becoming... You know, what she becomes in the end.
Oh, I mean, Gemma, you're such a great actor as well. Have you been BAFTA'd yet?
No.
Gemma, it's a matter of time, I'm sure of it.
When will we get to see Emma? When's
next
that
spring.
Out? Next spring. So you're busy filming right now?
No, I wrapped.
Oh, you've wrapped?
Yeah. That's all done. All done and dusted.
Brilliant. Thanks.
I'm available.
She's available right now. Do phone the hotline.
Shut up, Tom.
Well,
thanks, Gemma. Gentleman Jack continues tonight at 9 on BBC One.
Yeah.